Hi everyone, class 9th. This is Rashid Khan from Lakshmi Prasad Memorial Public School, Gola Bazar, Gorakhpur. Class, as you know, this is the topic given here as the structure of atom. So before going to the topic, here we'll have to know about that the basic and the fundamental type, fundamental topics, or you can say fundamental knowledge on which we have to discuss what it is actually regarding to the atoms. You know, all these things are made up of atoms and molecules. All these things are made up of matter, and matter is made up of what? The atoms and molecules. So the matter is the existence of atoms and molecules. We can say all the matters that can be made up of what actually? That can be made up of molecules and atoms. And you know that atom is the smallest unit of any type of element or anything else. The matter is composed of what? Atom and molecules. So atom is the basic smallest structure. So it is what we can say, it is the smallest unit by which any matter can be formed. But this concept is no more exists nowadays. Why? Because before moving to the topic here, we know about what is actually the atoms. In previous, we know that atom is supposed to be the This is the largest, or you can say, it is the smallest unit from which any matter can be assumed. But it is fails. Why? Because there is the many structures or the many charges through which we can assume that the atom cannot be a single one. So for that, it is further explained about, or it is further discovered that the atom is not the single. Atom is not the single. It has the its another smallest unit. That means atom is not the smallest unit. It can be made further by another the subunits as well. What these subunits are called actually? If there is a atoms, so the atom can further may be formed as the subatomic particles. Why this is called so? Because these subatomic particles are what actually? These subatomic particles may be as the further unit. Why? Because we suppose there is the three things by which these atom is composed of. What are these three particles? These three particles are, one is negatively charged, second is positively charged, and the last one is neither negative neither positive. That means it is a neutral charge. It has neutral charge. So what is the positive, negative and neutral charge as well? We know that these atoms are composed of three subatomic particles, that is called as electron. This one is called as electron. The positively charged subatomic particles are called as protons. And the neutrally charged particles is called as neutrons. So how we can say that there is a positive, negative and neutral charged? These particles may be of positive charge, negative charge and as well as the neutral charge. So how they be considered to as situated in an atom? Suppose if there is an element and that there is an arrangement, so how the arrangement can be possible? Here is the atom that can be composed of the electrons present in its surroundings. Why? Because this is a negative charge. If it is a negative charge, so this has to be acquire its outer region, that is an outer area. If it is negative charge, so might be something is there positive charged. So this one is the positive charge. Sorry, this one is already negative charge. Positive charge will be there at particular here as this one showing positive charge. Why? Because it is proved that the electrons revolve around a fixed circular in its elliptical path, that is called as circular circular path, or it is called as an elliptical path, in which electrons are revolving around the nucleus. It can revolve, these electron particles revolves around the, this can be revolved around the atom in a fixed path, circular fixed path. In this way the electron revolve. And why? Because the nucleus is present at center. Why? Because of the positive charge, proton present in them. Due to the protons, it represent as positively charged, and due to the electron, as because electron is negative charge and proton is showing positive charge, so there will be a bond created, due to which there is electron and proton get bind to one another. So what we can say, here is a small nucleus situated at the center, that is called as nucleus. In around the nucleus there is a path of electron in which the electrons are circulated or revolved. So we can say that this one is a negatively charged path, and this one, the nucleus or the center, it is a positive charge. So why electrons revolve around a circular path, and proton and neutron remain same at the center, due to which a bond formation takes place. These bonds help for the what actually? For combining to one another, for the electron and protons just situated in such a way that it could not be drawn from one another, and it could be only separated or maybe drawn to one another by using the extraordinary forces, or the forces or energy applied to it. If the energy applied, then it might be get separated. So here is the energy required for the separation of these particular type of a charges, that is positive charge and negative charge. We have observed about we have observed about there is the positive and negative charge. How these positive and negative charge created? So for that, you have seen the dry hairs when combing by the comb, there is a charge fluctuates are produced. The charge is of what? This one is called the electrostatic forces. Due to the electrostatic forces, there is an electric charge produces. You know that the glass rod is when rubs with the silk cloth, what will happen? The charges flow from the silk to the glass rod, and if the glass placed towards the balloon, then balloon get attracted. It is proved that there is a charge flow of charge takes place. In case of a ebonite rod, when rubbed with the cotton cloth, what will happen? There will be the flow of charge happen, there will be a transfer of charges takes place. So these are the different kinds of charges may produces. So why the atom cannot be produces their charge? On that regarding, here is a particles or charges came into the existence. And further discovery tells us about there due to the matter. Matter is composed of atoms and molecules. So the molecule, now then the molecules have only, sorry, the atoms have formed only by the only one type of particles. But by before this experiment, when the experiment done and when the discoveries takes place, it is proved that there is not only the atom composed of a single particles, but it can composed of what? It can be composed of different subatomic particles. So what are these subatomic particles actually? These subatomic particles are actually electrons, protons and neutrons. So why here is the electron, protons and neutrons are explained? We know that the electron, due to the negatively charged, it has to be represented by this way, and proton, due to the having positive charge in it, it can be shown like positive charge. But the neutron has neither the negative nor the positive charge, so it could be represented as 0. That means they have no charges at all. So we can say that there is a atom that can be having not only one single type of a charges, it can have 3 subatomic particles. These subatomic particles have the different charges in it. Of the electrons, protons and neutron, how they can be introduced? So I'll tell you about that. These 3 we know that there is a electron, proton and neutron. Electron, proton and neutron, how they can be come to the exist? So here is J.J. Thomson. Sir J.J. Thomson proved in 1897 proved that there is electrons. How this can be happen? The J.J. Thomson proved by having a cylinder and fill up the gas in it and produces a very high voltage electricity to them. There is a positive and negative terminal in which the electricity can provide. Due to providing this electricity at a very low temperature, there is a flow of electrically negative charge at the cathode. That we can say the cathode rays. Why? Because these rays arise from the cathode. So this one is called the cathode ray. And the cathode ray is called actually why? The cathode ray is said to be. Why? Because this ray is negatively charged. Why? Because it is negatively charged? Because this ray is arise from the cathode. So this can said to be the cathode ray. And this ray is about to negatively charge. So that one is said to be the electrons. And in further video, we will discuss about in detail.